hot chocolate. It's quite funny because most people actually drink coffee to wake themselves up. But for me, coffee makes me sleepy, so I decided to drink hot chocolate. So, for today's episode, or you could say for today's video, I'm going to be talking about 5 myths, specifically 5 heart myths, which people should know about. Come in. Right up. Hey guys, Aman here, and you're watching Heart Limits. I did it again. Hey guys and gals, Aman here, and you're watching Heart Limits. So let's jump into this. I was talking about 5 myths about your heart. So, myth number 1. Myth number 1 is that if you have heart disease, you need to take it easy. Well, in reality, it's actually the other way around. If you take it too easy, you can actually have some blood clots in your legs, and you can even have a decline in your overall physical condition. Physical activity not only strengthens your heart muscles, it also improves the blood flow to the brain and improves overall well-being and overall health. So to make sure how much exercise or how much activity you can do, make sure you consult your doctor, especially in cases if you just suffered a heart attack, to find out how much and to what extent are you allowed to exert effort. Myth number 2 is about the idea where having enough good cholesterol can offset your bad cholesterol. So that's your HDL versus your LDL. And the problem with this is it's actually old thinking where we believe that things could balance out. Something very positive and something quite negative could actually meet midway and form some type of health. But the problem is, in recent studies, it was found out that even though you have high good cholesterol, problem is, if you still have a certain amount of bad cholesterol, what happens is the cholesterol could still build up in your arteries and could basically still lead you to have a heart attack, a stroke, or any particular heart problem. So, be aware of this myth. Myth number 3. If your blood pressure is high, you will be able to feel it. And this is totally false, because the problem with high blood pressure, or otherwise known as hypertension, it's known as the silent killer, meaning that there are no symptoms that show until you finally have, say, a heart attack or a stroke. And the only way that you can actually measure hypertension or high blood pressure, or rather your blood pressure, is by having medical devices. Or, you know, that strap thing that you put over here, usually the doctor has, puts like some sort of stethoscope and starts pumping away. Well, that's basically the only way that you can really find out what your blood pressure is. So, if possible, do try to have your blood pressure checked. If you could, once a week or even once a month, that way you can keep track of how your state is. Myth number 4. Myth number 4 is a statement where the people believe that some superfoods can prevent heart disease. Well, sorry, but sad to say, there is no such thing as a superfood that can prevent heart disease. But there are diets which can help you prevent heart disease. Well, as you know, there are certain things which are pretty good for the heart. You have foods like walnuts, blueberries, pomegranate, and fish are good for the heart. But the problem is, if you don't have a full, complete diet, so one diet I could say which is really good for the heart, for preventing heart disease, is called the Mediterranean diet. So in my future videos, I'm going to explain more about this diet so that you can actually benefit from it. Myth number five is about lowering your risk of heart disease with the use of supplement and vitamins. Well, I'm sorry to tell you, but recent studies have showed, even supported by the American Heart Association, have showed that there has been tests with regards to these supplements, but there has been no real conclusive proof that they actually work. Antioxidant vitamins like E, C, and beta-carotene factor shows no proof in lowering heart disease risk. So the question is, what can you really do to lower the risk? Well, instead of taking the vitamins and the supplements, why not just take foods which are rich in those vitamins? You know, the best way is really the consumption of something which is natural. And in reality, not only does it fill your belly, it also kind of is a double deal thing. Because if you spend extra on supplements and you still need to buy the food, you're just having a useless extra spend, and usually these supplements are quite expensive. So what's important is that you buy nutritious foods with the color of the rainbow. Woo! Rainbow, like a unicorn! That's just strange, right? So there you have the five myths which we basically broke down with regards to your heart. So once again, Aman here, and you're watching Heart Limits. So I hope this video gave you lots of takeaways. Remember, these are myths, so they're not for real. They're things where people believe to be real. So I hope you take note of the things that I've said, and I hope that you live a better, healthy lifestyle.